Will you actually describe what it's like for you and a retailer, given the tariffs? I know that the analysts got it. I think that if you explain it a little to our viewers, they will know that this had to do nothing with how great Hasbro is, but everything with the way the toys are bought and sold in this country.
Well, you know, we set an objective this year to get back to growth. You mentioned Toys R Us, and we're getting back to growth year to date. We're up 5%. We said we would turn our European business around, and we're doing that. Our international business was up 4%, absent FX, with strong growth in Latin America and Asia Pacific. And then we've talked throughout the year how tariffs could have an impact, whether or not they were deployed or enacted, because of the way we go to market using an asset-light system with our retailers. In essence, our retailers ship in product on a direct import basis, and we ship in product domestically. As tariffs are being considered, and just through the third quarter, we saw several times conversation, communication, and elements that would say tariffs were coming, our retailer canceled those direct import orders, and then we brought them in domestically, those same inventories, except the inventory is sitting in Asia waiting for a direct import pickup, and we have to bring it in domestically through our supply chain. So in July and August, we saw shipments down. In September, we saw shipments rise appreciably, and our supply chain, working with a third-party provider, an asset-light model, we weren't able to bring in all the product that we had intended to bring in, and we continue to work through this process. Going forward, after fourth quarter 2019, our teams, like we always do, address these issues in real time. We have a way to go forward with our retailers where tariffs, whether they're enacted or not, will not have an impact on our business. But in the short term, it did have an impact, and we could see it in our business. We saw it in a reduction in our revenues and an increase in some expenses, particularly around shipping and warehousing, and that's what we were describing today.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer. Hashtag Mad Tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.